Hey, Time Lord, how's it going, man? Still haven't codex these damn argies yet. Getting close, though. Thank you. Okay, guys, we're going to take a short break while I make myself some food. Probably be about 15, 20 minutes, then we'll get back to the action. I still haven't codexed these things yet, but I'm pretty close. Maybe we'll just go ahead and move to some bigger ones and get it over with. I don't know yet. But first, food! Thank you. Hey, Sucks, how's it going, man? Just enjoying some food right quick. How are you doing tonight? Pretty good today, feeling pretty good. Wish I could get these damn Argonauts done, but you know, they take a while since I'm not shooting the bigger ones. But after we're done here with these Argies, we're gonna go finish up the codex on these Kirbys. Yeah, nice. Yeah, I don't know. I haven't tried those yet, but I'm sure I will eventually. But the Ortons, yeah, those drop lots of orange paint. They drop another color, too. I can't remember what it is. Green paint, I think. Yeah, bow calls can be, eh. You just gotta get the right ones with them, I guess. Unless you go out to Mutation Station, those guys usually pay out pretty good. Yeah, green and olive, that's the one. I knew they dropped some other colors too. But yeah, the best bet for bow calls is to go out to Mutation Station. Those guys out there pay really good. And I know the guy, well, I don't know the guy personally, but I know the landowner isn't in any kind of society that does any kind of scamming or anything like that, as far as I know. So, safe place to go hunt. I think if I'm not mistaken, Coram Coast has bow calls also. Oh yeah, sometimes you get that though, man. You know how the game is. Love it and love to hate it. Yeah, those are the mutated ones out there at the Mutation Station and at Coram Coast. I think the ones at Coram Coast are level 14, though. I'm not sure. It's been a minute since I've talked to David Joker about what he's got out there spawning. Really? wonder if maybe they're doing like a massive overhaul of it or something. Maybe somebody finally got tired of it not working right. Good if they were doing a wiki update. That's needed that for quite a long time. For those that don't know, there's a new token coming with Halloween Mayhem called a cosmetic token. I guess you're going to be able to buy clothes and other cosmetic items from the Mayhem vendor now. I think they're actually also kind of working on the way the economy works for free-to-play and low-depot players. I think that's what the actual intention of the twin tokens was, because, you know, that'll give a free-to-play or low-depot player an extra income. Understand the tokens themselves will not be tradable, but the items that you can buy with them are. So they're just like Mayhem tokens, but just for clothing and such. Maybe they'll have some special Mayhem clothing or something in there again, like they did the 1 year for Skull Candy. I don't really know. They didn't really release too many details about them yet. They did release those details, but they said for more details, wait until the announcement for Mayhem. It's about 2:21 in the morning here, yeah. But that's okay. I you know, we're the night shift around here. We do things overnight. But yeah, it's late for normal people here, but for me, nah, it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon to me right now. Even though it's 2:25 in the morning here. But yeah, just like working the night shift, I guess you could say. Doesn't bother me. Yeah, I don't know. Last night after taking a break, I was kind of struggling a little bit. towards the end there, I was getting kind of tired. Especially if you're doing something very repetitive, like hunting the same mob over and over and over and over again. Sometimes you can get into a rhythm and not even know that you're asleep. Your body just kind of takes over. They call that autopilot. That happened in Tropia, but there's been a few times in EVE Online back in the day, and after playing for, you know, 28 hours or so straight, monitoring center for security, correct. I'll tell you something else that's about as exciting as watching paint dry. Watching a whole lab full of computers do their Windows updates. In my case, especially when the previous interns weren't smart enough to turn on Windows updates. Sometimes I would find a whole lab of computers that hadn't been updated in like 6 months because nobody updated them. But that's what you get when you intern at a college, I guess. Yeah, that's about, let's see, I think we were using Windows 98 at the time, and then we had just switched to Windows XP, so you can imagine how nasty that was. Because, yeah, we didn't even bother with Windows ME. Oh, yeah, 95, 98, NT, Windows Neptune that they never released. Neptune was supposed to be the networking version, oh, but yeah. I don't know. Windows ME was, I mean, for some people it worked great, for others it was an absolute nightmare, kind of like Windows 8 was. Yeah, 98 always was pretty good for games. Wasn't too good for most of everything else, but games it was pretty good. Oh man, that brings me back. Good old Pentium 233. That was back when there were three chip manufacturers. Intel, Cyrex, and AMD had just started. Hey, Avalanus3D, how's it going, man? We got an ad starting in about 30 seconds, so I'll see you guys on the other side of the ad break for those that are not subscribers. Sorry about that. I wish I could make all my streams commercial free, but however, you know, I gotta make some money somewhere. Thank you. Yeah, man, them were the days. Okay, guys, I don't know if you've heard about this yet or not, but apparently I'm getting reports that level 3 exosaurs no longer drop blazar fragments. Now, we don't know if this is a bug or if it's an intentional update to remove them permanently from the loot pool of that mob. I'm still looking into it. I haven't found anything really about it yet, but, you know, it could just be one of those things they snuck in on us. However, if you do know for sure and can confirm this or otherwise let us know what's going on, or know somebody that might, have them get in touch with us or you, and somebody give me an update so I know for sure what the deal is on this. But apparently for now, it seems that level 3 Exosaur are no longer dropping blazar fragments. As far as I know, Berklid still dropped them, yes. But the Exosaur thing, yeah, that's going to hit a lot of people, because there's a lot of people that use those for Codex progression and things like that, and they farm the Blazers from them, so... But as soon as I have a definitive answer, I will let everybody know as well. Either on the Discord or probably through here as well. I will also see about if I can come up with something to recommend for a replacement for those. Berklid's probably seems like a nice one, because I think they still drop them. Haven't heard anything about them not dropping from Berklid's. Let's see, I would say maybe Barklids and Snabble Snots. And I just got another twin token. Damn, these twin tokens have been dropping like crazy. I'm up to 32 of them today already. I think when I started, I had 4 of them. Yeah, that's the thing. Most people use them for the Viceroy upgrades, too. I forgot about that. That's one of the reasons why you can get some pretty good markup for them. Thank you. So one thing I would suggest is keep an eye on the market value for blazers. They might actually go up a bit. Yeah, you need them for tier upgrades as well. And I think there's a couple of blueprints that you need them for, but not very many. I think it's less than 10. But they're like super uber freaking stuff I'm never going to be able to craft for 20 years yet. So I'm not worried about that. Hey, good job, Angel, if you're listening. Congratulations on the global. That's awesome. You're just a global getting machine now, aren't you? Hey, good morning, Mary. How's it going? Good to see you. Oh, I'm doing pretty good. Well rested. Wish these Argies would hurry up in Codex so I can get to the Kirbys, but they're level 3, so they're going to take a minute. Congratulations, Angel, on the 50 Ted Global a minute ago. That's awesome. I'm glad you're getting a lot more of those. So Mary, I was telling everybody here, I don't know exactly what the deal with this is, but it seems that level 3 Exosaurs out at North Swamp Camp are not dropping blazers anymore. Now, we don't know if it's a bug or if it's intentional, but... Yeah, Angel just got her Globalana Argonaut adult. I'm telling you, Argies are good for lots of things. They're good for Codex, they're good for skilling, they're good for Globals. Yeah, there aren't as many mobs that drop those anymore as there used to be. I just keep kind of letting them stack up in the corner. I wish I still had all the ones I had before, because I had almost 5,000 of them. But I sold them long, long ago. Since then, they've been stacking up in my storage. No, the smaller ones, global, smaller, and they don't have as high of quality of loot. You can global on them though, all the way up to, I think, 200 fed. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm talking about the Argonauts, Mary. I must not have been paying attention there for a minute. But yeah, it seems they're not dropping them anymore. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if it's permanent or a bug. Or maybe that's what we get now instead of Blazers, is those new tokens they're going to introduce with the new Mayhem. Or Halloween Mayhem, I mean. Yeah, I'm kind of the same way at the moment. I'm just codexing these for the time being. Kind of where the state of my ped flow is at the moment. I'm still getting skills and loot, so I guess you can't complain too much. Actually, that's not true. Everybody start complaining, because usually when people start complaining, people start getting globals. Or at least that's the way it seems to work in Entropia. Unless you're global proof like me. But when I turn global proof, that usually means there's a big global or possibly a Hoth coming. Yeah, I've killed 713 of these bastards today and no global yet. And I killed a few before I started the tracker. I was killing them for probably about an hour before I realized I didn't have the tracker on. Vixens are always fun. I've got the pet vixen, the blonde one. I just... Now I gotta get the damp here.